Inner Universe community. Namaste. Are you someone who keeps clinging to the past? I've met lot of people who just cling to their past and then bring it to the present and clutch their past like anything, and just they are conditioned so much to not let it go. But it is hampering the way they are living their life in the now, in the present moment. And they could have actually enjoyed and done so much. But since they are clinging to the past, they are missing out on living their life fully. I'll give you a few examples. I met someone the other day and I was surprised to meet her actually. And she had unkempt hair and not properly dressed and all. I said, "What happened? Were you sick or something?" "No, no, no. I'm absolutely fine." "Oh, that's so great to hear. You are fine, but you look very weak." "Oh, don't you know? I met with an accident." I was actually taken aback. "My God, you met with an accident? I did not know about it. I'm so sorry." "No, I have not been doing this and that. I have not been doing anything. I'm not pursuing my hobbies. I'm not working at all. I just don't feel very good." "Oh my God, I really felt sorry when I heard that. And when was that accident?" "Oh, that was 19 years back." 19 years back. And you have unkempt hair and this is the way you are dressed up now? After 19 years also, you are still clinging to that incident. You could have just moved on. So here's a check that we all have to make. Are you one of those who is clinging to any particular incident in your life that had happened in your childhood? "I'm like this. I'm always angry because I had a difficult childhood." But that was your childhood. And you have grown up after that. You could have worked on yourself. You could have worked on your personality. You can always make changes. Why is someone else, the behavior of your family members or your friends or something that happened in your childhood, guiding you till the time you have grown up? Now, this is the time when everyone is going to their colleges, new colleges. And I met a lady who still felt guilty about her getting a 7 GPA in her college. And she was like, "Why did I make that mistake? Actually, you know, that party which I attended when I was in college." And I was like surprised looking at her. It was something in the past. It is gone. My friend wrote on the social media that she was really feeling bad because her father had died on that day, about 5 years back, and she was very unhappy. And it is very natural. Her father died of old age. He was very old and about 95 years of age. So the best thing you can do while remembering your parents who have died is that you start doing what they love to do. Like my mother loved decorating the house. She loved to cook for her children. And that is what I do whenever I remember her. I start bringing plants inside the house and I start decorating the house. I start changing the bed covers and I put the best bed covers. And when the house looks beautiful, it is like she's appreciating me for decorating the house so well. So it is a choice you can make every moment. I don't say that you will not feel bad, but then you can make a choice of, instead of feeling sad while remembering them, why not do something which will make you happy remembering them? Anything that they like to do, start doing that. And do you know, they are always around you. They would like to see you happy. The thing is, you are not able to see them because they are at a different frequency. They are pure light. They are pure souls now. But they can see you. Would your parents like to see you sad? No. So this is just a suggestion. Whenever you think of anyone deceased in your family or your friends, start doing something which they love to do. That is the best compliment you can give them, and the best way to remember them would be by smiling and then thinking about them and not feeling sad about their not being there. Especially when someone has died of illness, you do not have to think about yourself. You have to think that they were saved of lot of pain and hospital treatment. So it was good for them, and that was something which the higher source thought would be okay for them. So now what you have to do is to accept that they are no more with you and start thinking about them with a smile on your face. Start thinking of all the beautiful things they ever said to you or did for you. The other day I met a really young man, and he had just started going to office, and he said that he just detests going to his office because he has always been coming first in his class. But in office, the parameters of judgment of whether this employee is on the fast track or he is good or not, they are different. So now he's finding it really difficult to cope with that. So this is also another example of clinging to your past. You have to move on. Now you have been planted into a different environment. See what is required. What are the changes required in that particular environment? Keep learning and upgrading your skills. And you cannot be a winner all the time. So now there is something to judge within yourself. There is something to clean and clear and update within yourself. Is it your ego? Is it too much expectation from the environment you are in? So you have to decide on your own, and the best way to decide is to listen to your own intuition. Your inner guidance system can guide you the best way. Today the youth is really fond of traveling. They will travel all around the world, here and there, which is a great thing because you learn a lot. You open up as you travel around the world. You open up to different kinds of languages, cultures and people. There is another place you should visit, and it is within. Just sit, meditate and go within, because nothing on the outside can give you complete happiness and peace. Ultimately, you have to travel within, and the treasure that lies within cannot be compared with anything outside, because the whole universe is within. So understand yourself. Do what you love to do. Be yourself. Be authentic. And live your life according to your choices, your own ways. And remember that the freedom you like for yourself, you should be able to give to others. So when you are being yourself, you have to let the other person be. So this is all from me. Thank you so much. This is your mentor and spiritual guide, Sanchita Pandey. Namaste. I love you. May peace be with you.